In this session, I'm going to talk about posting groups within Business Central. Posting groups are mandatory fields throughout Business Central that allows you to post to your GL, your trial balance numbers, if you will. So without proper setups of posting groups, whether it be AR, AP, inventory, you will not be able to complete a transaction. So let's take a quick look at some of the posting group tables, and we'll start there and move into one of the main posting group setups. So as I mentioned, for customers, vendors, and items, I'm going to go to the customers. I'm going to go into a card, and each card for customer specific, they have a customer posting group. A vendor has a vendor posting group. An item has an inventory posting group. And you'll see it's a code, it will be needed. This is a mandatory field. And what this dictates, think of this as the balance sheet side. This code, it could be alphanumeric, could be just numeric, could be alpha, could be alphanumeric. If I drill down, and you'll see that this code, in this example, I only have one code domestic. I could make as many codes as I want and link them all to the same GL account or to different GL accounts. So in theory, I could have two or three different receivables accounts, and I'm going to dictate it based on the code. So every customer has to have a code. It's just a matter of which code it belongs to, which will dictate which receivables GL account it goes to. So this is my link to my GL. Right, and I could have other fields, which is, you know, if I do payment discounts, where do I want my payment discounts to go? If I charge for finance charges, interest amounts, and additional fees, I could have them go to whatever GL account I want them to go to, based all on a code. So as I create my customers, a posting group, customer posting group, needs to have this code for it to transact. If this is empty, and you select this customer onto a sales order, it's going to error out on you and says, oh, I need a posting group code because I don't know what receivable account to put it into. So that's where this comes to play, right? So the customer posting group, and I'm going to show you real quick. If I go to a vendor card and I go to any vendor, I'm going to scroll down to my invoicing tab and same thing, vendor posting group. In this case, it has the same code. I drill down. And I see, based on my code, what payables account is it going to go to? So same concept, whether I'm a customer, a vendor, or an inventory item, when I'm on an inventory item, the posting group is going to dictate what inventory account is going to go to. In this case, since I'm on a vendor, what payables account am I going to go to when I transact to this vendor? So notice the common theme is your balance sheet side of things, right? Inventory, payables, receivables. Based on a code within a posting group dictates what GL number it's going to go to. Okay, and again, I could have as many different codes as I want to classify what type of vendor or customer item it is, which also in turn dictates what GL impact it's going to go to. So that's one sort of a posting group that is mandatory that you need to populate on a record by record basis. Okay, now I'm going to show you more of a larger type of posting group table. So this is the general setup, the general posting group setup. This also has, on a customer level, a general business posting setup where it's going to dictate, you're going to say, based on my customer's business type, and I'm going to go back to that card in a few minutes. And what I'm selling, which this is based on the inventory card, which I'll point out in a few minutes. What sales do I want it to go to? So in this example, if my customer is a domestic customer that I sell retail type items to, I want my sales to go to this account. I could dictate whether I want my credits to go to the same sales account or go to a different sales account. If I offer discounts, you'll see I have different discounts, GL accounts to go to. Whereas over here in this line, if my customer is domestic and my sales are service type, then I want my sales to go to this GL account and so forth. So you're going to dictate based on codes that you set up on a customer level and an inventory level, item level, where your sales, credits, discounts, and not only that, it's obviously your cost of sales. So if I keep on going down, and you'll see my cost account. So where is my cost of goods going to go based on the type of codes that I load into this setup table? So let's go into a customer again. So my customer, as we just talked about, we talked about the customer posting group. Here we have a business posting group. So my business posting group, again, I could have more than one. I could, again, use the leverage to what type of customer it is, you know, what type of business, what type of industry is it. You could use that as a leverage of a code to dictate for reporting what type of industry specific customers am I dealing with. The customer can only be assigned one of these codes. So you assign them this code, and based on this code, because it's a domestic customer, I'm going to dictate where my sales are going to go. So keep in mind, now this is the customer card, business posting group of domestic. So now I'm also going to go to my inventory item card. And if I go into my details of an item, you will see here's my product posting group, which in here, if you remember, you saw retail, right? So my product posting group is a mandatory field, and you assign this one code to your items. And again, I could drill down and you're going to see retail services, miscellaneous items without tax. So you're going to apply one of these codes to your item card. So you apply business posting group on a customer, product posting group on an item, and that will dictate where your sales and cost of sales are going to go to your GL. So again, I'm going to drill down into retail and go to my setup table. And lo and behold, it shows me, okay, if I sell to my customers of domestic a retail product, then I know my sales and cost of sales is going to go to whichever I apply here in this setup table. Very important that this is set up, because if you're missing anything, any codes on a customer card, any codes on an item card, or you don't have the appropriate GL accounts when it comes to sales or cost of sales, the system's going to error on you and you won't be able to post a sales invoice, a sales credit memo, a sales order. So it's important to understand that the posting groups on your customers, on your items, on your vendors need to have those codes applied to each record. And once those codes are applied to each record, dictate where it's going to go into your GL account. Because obviously, if you think about it, if these are empty and you have nothing in there, then the system, when it goes through a posting routine, it doesn't know where the landing point is. So you have to tell it where the landing point is by your GL number. And you could have as different GL numbers, as I mentioned here. Some people would like to have their credits go into a different GL account. Some people just have it moshed together all into one. That's your preference. It depends on how you want to set it up. So that's a high-level overview of how posting groups work within Business Central. Thanks for watching. If we could further assist you, please reach out to us here at epcgroup.net.